Hello everyone, welcome to lesson 34 of our GoLang course. We covered functions in the last lesson, and following up in this lesson, we are going to cover variadic function parameters. So let's get started. Go, like some other languages, supports the concept of variadic parameters. This means you can pass variable numbers of argument to a function. In simpler words, the number of parameters you pass to a function is not fixed for variadic parameter functions. Like we saw in the previous example, where we were defining say hi to someone and we had an argument of name. So the function was only accepting one parameter. But for variadic parameter functions, the number of parameters is unlimited. Variadic parameters provide the flexibility when you are uncertain about the exact number of arguments that will be passed to a function. There are a couple of rules for a function to accept variadic parameters. The three dots are the syntax used to denote variadic parameter. It must be placed before the type of the parameter. Since Go is a strongly typed language, all parameters passed to a function should be of the same type. The second rule states, in a function's parameter list, if a parameter is declared variadic, it must be the last parameter. This is because it captures all the remaining arguments passed to the function. When you receive variadic parameters in a function, they are treated as a slice. This means you can perform slice operations on them, like iterating over elements or using functions like len, cap, or the range to iterate over it. Here is a syntax of function with variadic parameters. Just like a regular function, we will have func keyword followed by the function name, then the parameter name followed by parameter type. Notice that we are specifying three dots before it to say that param name would be a parameter of variable length, then the return type, followed by the code block for the function. Please note that if a function accepts multiple parameters along with the variadic parameter should be the last one. Let's look at an example. So here we defined a function named sum, which accepts nums as a variadic parameter. We state that using the three dots in front of int. Since num is treated as a slice inside the function, we can range over it. So I create a total variable with value 0. Then we iterate over the nums and add it to the total and return the total. So what the function sum is doing is going over all the parameters passed to the function and returning the sum of it. What we can do is sum, I can pass one parameter if I want, I can pass 2, 3, 4, or however number of arguments I want to pass to this function since it's a variadic parameter. We can store the return value in s and do fmt println s, and that should give you sum of all the int values that we provided to the function. And there you have it. We have 37 printed to the console, which is sum of all these numbers that we provided to the sum function, which accepts variadic parameters of int type. Now I can also do this where I created nums, which is a slice of int, and then pass it to the sum with a spread operator. The spread operator separates each value of the slice into individual values, basically satisfying the variable parameter list. And if we run the program, you will see it works fine. If you haven't noticed till now, another example of variadic parameters is the println function. If you look at the signature of println, it accepts variadic parameter of any type. I can do s, a, x, 10, and everything will work. We can do this again because println accepts variadic parameters. So that works fine. In some programming languages, you can specify default values for function parameters, or you can explicitly name the parameters when calling the function. Go does not support these features. In Go, you must pass all the required arguments to a function in the correct order. It's considered a best practice in Go and in programming in general to keep the number of parameters in a function to a minimum. This enhances the readability and maintainability of the code. Functions with fewer parameters are easier to understand and use. This is one of the reasons named or default parameters are not allowed, as they are usually employed for functions accepting multiple parameters, which is usually greater than 2. If you find yourself needing to pass a large number of parameters to a function, or if you want to provide optional values, it's often more organized and readable to use a struct, which is a composite data type that you can define. It allows you to group related values together. This way you can pass just one argument to the function, which is the struct itself. So here we have an example of how you can do this. Instead of passing operation value 1, value 2, value 3 in this parameter list, we just created a struct of type math operation options, and then we provide the options to the math operation function. And the math operation function can use this option to calculate or perform the programming logic. That's it for the lesson. Let's summarize what we have learned till now. We learned that variadic parameters denoted by ellipses or three dots in Go allow you to pass a variable number of arguments to a function. This means you can pass as many arguments as needed when calling the function, making it more flexible and versatile. In Go, unlike some other languages, you cannot assign default values to parameters. You cannot refer to parameters by their name when calling a function. Parameter must be provided in correct order. When you have a function that requires a large number of parameters, or you want to provide optional values, using a struct is a recommended approach. A struct allows you to group related data together, making the function call more organized and readable. That's it for the lesson. I hope you enjoyed it. Please feel free to ask any questions you may have. You can post a comment under the video or reach out to the Discord server. I will see you in the next lesson. Happy coding!